Well, I'll just start talking, I guess. I'll just assume that we're ready to go.
Yes.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Welcome back from an extended vacation to Fire Emblem Fallen Kingdom.
Hey.
Hello.
I got sick.
Hi. Yeah.
This is fun.
Yeah. I got sick, and I also was on vacation to go to a friend's wedding, and it was cool.
I was also sick that week.
Which worked out, I guess, in a weird sort of cosmic kind of way.
Until my parents decided to, this week wasn't going to work out, but I'm still here for a little bit.
Not here for a long time, I'm just here for a great time.
I'm here to be gay at least one war crime today.
Oh, we've already done a couple war crimes, don't worry about it.
Oh, yeah, no.
Well, we're already here, so we need to commit more.
We have two war crimes. Her name is Archie and Sky.
Don't stop me now.
Yes. War crime.
I'm gonna have a war crime. I'm having a ball.
Rookie.
What
numbers.
Are the four? We need more horses, though. We only have two horses now.
That's
we're
true.
Down to two horses.
Yeah,
we might get more.
We're lacking fans again.
That means it'll be easier to make them dance.
Yeah.
I've already taught Lavender how to dance.
Stop this.
I can do it again.
Stop this. We haven't even officially started session yet. Shut up.
No.
Sure, we have. When we last saw our heroes, we finally finished chapter one. It was
Yay.
A big fucking deal.
Okay.
Well, we got exceptionally mad at religion.
Yay!
Woo!
Some people just hated us on principle, and we want them dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a little bit.
Prince Siner has officially been made a permanent guest in one of their seven Koopa. In the castle at San Cordia.
Yeah, it's totally not the bougiest prison he's ever probably met.
I dare you to find him if you can.
There's seven towers on that castle.
But he is also given the express order to, well, get out of Dodge, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So, out of Dodge we get. We're marching for about a day and a half. And we're going to go ahead and make encampment here. Sort of in the border between the towns... Or no, excuse me, let me try that again. In the border between the Ecclesiarchy of Puera and the Bornai Polynational Democracy. We're going to be resting on the outskirts of a little town called, well, Respite.
Okay.
Mm. Yeah.
And say goodbye to this shitty-ass town, everybody.
Goodbye.
Yay.
Goodbye.
Bye. Thanks for the religious trauma.
So, this is where we say my Cordia is the premium Cordia now?
Yeah.
Yes.
But you can go ahead and set your characters up anywhere within the encampment here.
That's not my character. That was Nessa.
Sure was, buddy.
Don't steal Nessa. Oh, wait, hang on. Oh.
Anywhere?
Anywhere within the encampment.
Oh,
In here.
That's a lot of space.
Well, you said anywhere.
Why is he on? Okay.
Nessa, why are you fucking...
She felled it down.
There we go.
This is a place between places. This is a little bit of a liminal space in the desert.
Mm-hmm. Fancy.
The actual town of Respite is more,
there we go.
I want to say this way.
Okay.
North.
Well, not really north, but like... That would technically be west, if you want to look at the map, technically speaking.
Yeah. North is just where we're facing.
West. North can be whatever you think it is. But it's actually here.
The true North is the friends we made along the way.
The true North is making sure that this reference never gets referenced again.
No promises.
Wait.
That's
that
right.
That's
no, that backwards.
Yeah, no, that was backwards.
Got this. Yeah!
Woohoo! There you go.
Yes, bring back the doodling.
Yeah, oh my god, we haven't doodled in ages.
We really got invested. We got invested.
Yeah.
We got launched into the plot.
Yeah, which is understandable.
Yeah, truly.
Hey, at least Ark's crazy.
Because of some script.
Yeah. Just like how we let Ringo immediately look at whatever the fuck this was over here.
At the skeleton.
Is that it?
There's
a regular skeleton. Bones. Haunted.
And the bones.
Bones are haunted.
Where'd Ringo go?
He's right over here.
Oh, okay.
Ringo go.
On the box.
Where'd Ringo go?
Hello.
I was over on the bench.
Still in the box.
This is a time to rest, to relax, to kind of reflect on your journey so far. You've been ordered to find, well, something. At least one of you has.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of up to him whether or not he's going to, you know, give out more information about that, but hey.
Mm-hmm.
Should we roll for initiative just for going on turns, or should we just, you know, go on vibes?
I may only have enough for one vibes. Turn.
Well, it's peachy time then.
All right, cool. Because I don't know with how my family is. If it means, hey, we're leaving in like an hour, or we're leaving in 2 hours.
We're leaving in hours.
Now.
Nowers.
Nowers.
Picks you up.
Turns work on Mario seconds.
By the scruff of your neck.
If you suddenly hear me go, I gotta go.
Yeah, just suddenly we hear just like, and there's no more Peachy.
Yep. Oh. Or we just hear thunk, thunk, thunk. Dokie dokie. Well, I have my sheet open. Good, good. I was mindful enough to do that. So,
dope.
Oh,
Mr. Center
got two balls.
Not for long.
Not for long. One come.
I'm sorry.
You should be only fun. What's wrong with you?
He just sees Ringo put her, kind of have her hands at her hips, just like. So you want to talk about what kind of happened back there, bud? Is now the time to ask what the hell happened back there? Other than what we know happened back there?
In the room.
Yeah. You were in the room.
Yeah, well, like... She kind of just... puts her hand on the side of her neck, kind of trying to rationalize how she's going to speak. Just, like, did he say where we needed to go? To be exact. Other than
let's gather everyone and make sure everyone's on the same page.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Yeah.
Girl, go around, try to round everyone up just to get everyone on the same page.
Okay, you round so everybody up.
Okay.
He's still kicking rocks.
Zayn, your rock pile keeps growing. What's happened?
What?
He's just kicking rocks.
Oh, I see.
He was laying on rocks, he was sitting on rocks, he's kicked a rock.
He'd climb on rocks.
The rock collection has scattered across the entire camp.
So we're telling the NPCs as well, or like...
I'd figure, yeah.
Oh, okay. Scaring,
so they don't have to, yeah. It's just being told to everyone. Oh. But, so, I know a lot of you were... about the city, but we had to get out of there pretty quickly. I'm under the request of Eyes to guide this party to respite to meet up with an acquaintance of ours, or an informant, by the name of Kanan. Unfortunately, our plans in San Cordia did not necessarily play out the way we thought, so Eyes informed me that he doesn't plan on being held up too long there, but we will be without Eyes for a little bit. They, needless to say, foreign government was not too happy with our attack, as they call it, on their troops on the outskirts of their capital. We tried to defend ourselves, but they weren't too keen on listening.
They never have been.
So the main goal right now is get to respite and see where that leads us, but that's pretty much all I have to go off of right now. If you have any concerns, I'm welcome to hear them, but for as of right now, I'm acting leader of this group until we reach respite, or until Eyes resumes or rejoins us later down the line. I don't do this out of self-claiming. This was discussed, but I requested this back in Calma right before we went on our missions within the town.
I see. I get it. I do. It's just, it's almost like a calculated risk you took. If that makes sense. Just like he knew. It's like he knew the risks beforehand. And I'm not saying that it's not a peaceful area. It used to be. Pretty much has always been, but I guess I shouldn't be surprised if the capital is gonna act this way.
Definitely didn't seem favorable towards us, regardless. But if you have any concerns, feel free to let me know. But we'll be camping here for now. But we'll head out to respite once we're all prepared and ready to go.
Of course. Sounds good to me.
You got some time.
Yeah.
Here?
We do.
That's basically it. You tramble. Plus, we got in the camp.
Roll my time.
Scatter!
Scatter!
Quick, roll play. Go, go, go.
Go, go, quick, quick, while we have time. I'm curious about things, so I'm just going to waddle over here. So, y'all go ahead.
Waddle. Waddle away.
What's wrong with it again?
Sweet that the duck song is done.
We live in a weird timeline.
We're the post duck song.
We live in a duck song and llamas with hats.
Llamas with hats. Like, oh my god. He actually got like
back to back. I feel like they talk to each other at this point. What the fuck do you mean? Tokido, I'm sorry. Just one off comment thing. So Tokidoki did the design for the mascot for the Vatican.
Oh yeah, Luce.
Mm-hmm.
Luce. Oh yeah, I saw that.
Today, that was not what I was expecting to see on my timeline. Go ahead, though. Carry on.
Oh, yeah.
Well.
So, mind if I jump in?
You may jump.
Okay. And this is kind of directed more to Phoenix and Nessa, Zane's gonna say, can anyone else vet that I personally appointed Geralt as backup leader?
Oh, we're already getting into this, are we? The power struggle is real. Kill yourself.
Yeah.
Ew.
I'm kidding. I didn't mean that. Strike that one from the record.
Okay.
I mean, I didn't hear him directly tell Geralt, but I do trust Geralt.
I didn't see anything either, but it would make the Geralt does make the most logical sense. He's Alberician. He's from... Wait, would I know he had some sort of like leadership role in the character? Or did he just...
I don't know if captains come up outside the courtroom.
Okay. I mean, he's fought in...
Can't remember.
Something regarding Albrecht before.
Yeah.
And
he is also Alberician. I do trust his judgment.
Yeah.
I did introduce him as captain of the...
But I wasn't in the courtroom.
Yeah.
I'm going to say I'm not here for this.
It was, though.
Okay.
And so, like, that's me in character bringing it up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, then, yeah, even more so, I do trust his judgment. It would... He makes the most logical sense as our lead until Ice returns.
Why not Zaradon?
Well, I mean, we don't know much about Zaradon's past right now. Like, I do trust Zaradon, too. That's a weird one.
I know I've been with the group a much more limited time, but I feel like I trust him a bit more.
I mean, I trust Zaradon and Geralt equally, but I do also trust Eyes, and if Eyes is the one who appointed Geralt, then I trust that judgment.
Alright.
Why do you ask?
Oh.
Great question.
Great question.
Great question. Next question.
Great question. Next question.
Nervous sweat.
That's a great question. We're just going to put that up in the fridge so everybody can see it.
Yay!
I am just, you know, concerned at the disappointment we faced Okay, deep down he's just salty.
Just mad that he's not in charge.
I want to be the special boy.
God. Look, Zayn, as someone who also wasn't in that courtroom, I get it. I'm also salty about the outcome. I feel like, I don't know, if I was in that room, I feel like I also could have done something to help as well.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe what you're thinking is something to do with that. Obviously, I'm not going to throw words in your mouth, but at the end of the day, we can't do what happened. And from the sounds of what Geralt and others said about the Archbishop backing Sancordia, he wasn't going to listen to any of us. So I understand being salty about the outcome.
Yeah, I feel like I agree with Zeron tactics more as well.
That's fine, to each their own. And Zeradon's tactics are helpful in some cases, but I think Geralt's tactics are helpful in others.
Pulling the curtain just aside here, the only reason that Geralt is in charge in the first place is because he had the highest support at the time with Geralt.
No,
that is amazing.
The characters don't know that, so...
No, the characters don't have any indication of what support points are.
That is fucking great.
That doesn't surprise me, though. That is hilarious.
You're telling me.
Look at my certification.
There's a system of points that exists somewhere that determines how good of friends we are. Fuck you.
Oh, look, the post just went down. Oh. Right.
Imagine that. I beat you on my support points.
They think you're crazy. What do you mean they think I'm crazy?
Well, if you insist we can trust him, I will wait and see.
Believe me, I've been traveling with him since Ramo. We both received the same letter in this army, and I've seen him on the battlefield many a times. I do trust him. And I trust Eyes.
I hope you realize that my quietness here is more just me prepping things for.
Oh, yeah.
Background. Oh, you're good.
That's fine.
No, it's fine. I'm done with my little moment for now. If someone else wants to do things,
let's say, oh, I don't know. Let's see, Nessa and Phoenix are talking. Geralt's over there, brooding.
I'm over there,
brooding.
I really just stepped back because I'm like, I'm probably not here for this conversation.
Yeah, I was gonna say he was sulking, but knights don't sulk; they brood.
Yeah.
Oh, very medieval. They brood.
I understood that reference.
There you go. Sure. What are you? Oh, I'm Geralt.
I don't know. Kicking around, thinking about where my boy may be.
My horse is dancing. I don't know why.
That's why. Who did this?
Who is this man? What sort of devil is he?
He's got me caught in a trap and
stop.
There is nothing.
What Ringo's looking at.
God,
yeah.
We can't keep it off for 40 minutes.
Sorry.
I'm sorry.
I don't know. What's Zaradon up to?
I'm just sitting off to the side, kind of obsessively going over his equipment.
As you do.
Yeah, he's. Yeah, it's like at this point, he's just kind of waiting for the next target, essentially.
No target here.
He's
also brooding.
Everyone's brooding their corners.
Knights don't pout, they brood.
Now I'm just picturing a little pouty knight with just a little, like, lower lip out. Arms crossed.
I'm not pouting or brooding. I'm just impressed, but there's a fucking dragon skeleton out here, dog.
Oh, yeah, I feel like Zayn is more than one than that, too.
Yeah, just Ringo's kind of like, okay.
Is that the dragon?
I think so. Can I see if I think it's so? Or is it actually?
The bones?
Yeah.
You're willing to investigate the fucking bones?
It's interesting things that you put on the map.
It's an interesting thing! Would you want me to go investigate the human skeleton over there in the other corner?
I mean, I don't think I'd prefer it. I think I would just be neutral towards you investigating both the sets of bones. Yeah. Sure, investigate the dragon bones. I don't know, give me a perception check.
Okay, I see. Oh, I gotta remember.
I think I know shit from fuck.
Hold up, I have to remember how to fucking roll again.
The 1d100.
Yeah.
And it's intelligence, right?
Well,
perception.
What
I think
I thought you said perception.
Yeah, perception, oh, yeah. And yeah, that's with him. It's a 30. I have a 39 in perception, so.
Checking all my stuff. You do. Okay. Well. While you were investigating the skeleton, you, of course, can tell that it is draconic in nature.
Mm-hmm.
You're getting the feeling that there was probably at some point in this general area a big war fought, and the sands shifting and changing and such unveil all sorts of bones every now and then.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense.
You also find 100 gold.
Okay.
in its mouth.
Oh, neat. Bro. He's candy.
Ooh, he's candy.
My treasure senses are tingling.
We're going to run the skeletons now.
It is a desert map.
God, Fire Emblem did that with desert maps.
Yeah, they just sneak little treasures every now and then in places.
You could walk any tile and find treasure, probably.
Only if you're a thief, though. Every other class, it's like a 1 in like 15% chance of finding the object.
Mm-hmm.
Thieves are guaranteed in some game. What? Just... What did I say? 1 in 15%?
Yeah, 1 in 15%.
So yeah, 1% chance. I don't know.
That's still a 1-1 point late.
Oh.
I don't even have an excuse. I'm just stupid.
I know.
No.
We knew what you meant.
I know you knew what I meant, and I know I knew what I meant, but it doesn't mean it wasn't so funny.
Yeah, no. It just wasn't grammatically correct.
No,
today,
no.
Today, Fire Emblem Fallen Kingdom, they can't do math. None of them. Not a single
that's
damn
not a step.
Oh, my bad,
excuse
my bad.
Me, Vulcan I'm in engineering
can...
school.
Yeah, my bad. Two of them can do math.
I'm also here. I fake it till I make it, mostly.
I require one of the human calculators or a real calculator to survive.
One of the human calculators.
Well, you've got me, so it's fine.
You have
like,
my
I'm
sword.
Not good at fast arithmetic or multiplication, but damn if I can't do calculus.
And my axe, not now, Gimli.
Not now, Gimli.
Hello, cats.
Hello. It's a dragon Hello, skeleton over there.
Yes, I saw.
Could have made a really bad joke. Chose not to.
Those are your bones, boy?
I think I found some of your family.
Ooh. I don't think that's a good job after their conversation, but...
No, not after their support conroe.
Something jumped the bones? I don't know.
Pretty sure we'll find some human skeletons. Don't worry.
By Allah, you people are dogs. I shall continue to DM as usual.
By Talos, this can't be happening.
Oh, it be.
I found 100 gold in its mouth.
Oh, nice.
Hmm. So, always good to check, I guess. You never know what a dragon or a human might have on their corpse. I guess.
I fucking guess.
Ringo's life experiences with corpses are a little narrow, so just
good.
Yeah, especially like, you know, one that's this old.
Yeah. If it starts coming to life and asking where its fucking money is, Ringo like, doesn't know what you're talking about, and Ringo is obviously not the one with its gold in her pocket.
Hey, pal, you see my bones?
Where the fuck is my money?
Hey, man, we just want to
as long as you don't have that attitude when we come across an actual cemetery.
Why would I do that to an actual cemetery?
I don't know. I've only known you a few days.
I mean, yeah. No, I don't go body pilfering usually at cemeteries. It's not a hobby of mine.
I'm all for swindling, but I draw the line at grave robbery.
Yeah, I don't like desecrating the dead.
I want to steal it.
I am okay with stealing price, like gems every now and then if the person had it coming. But even then, I think
I am not as good as with the sneaking. I'm better with words.
Yeah. I can trick them into thinking I've read their fate while someone else gets it. But, yeah, no.
Interesting plan.
Ha. In your future, there will be a thievery.
Just right now.
The future is now.
You will be mugged. Give me your money.
Your fucking money. Loads book.
With religious intent?
No. Dubious.
With dubious intent.
Ah, yes. My favorite kind.
Mm-hmm. Could be dubious intent.
Stop!
I love that.
Dubious intent.
Alright. Before we get too off track here, thank you for watching Fallen Kingdom. I hope you're enjoying today's session so far. Please consider liking and subscribing down below, and maybe hit that bell to get notified of future uploads. The channel recently passed 200 subscribers, and I want to thank you all immensely. We're all really glad that you're enjoying our escapades so far. It does mean a lot to us to see those numbers go up every week. I don't want to take up too much time here, so let's just go ahead and get back to our session. But thank you.
You guys are silly.
Go ahead, you can co-cast me now.
You're stuck with us, Chief.
I'm the one who hired you, basically.
Yeah.
You're fired. You can't fire me, I quit. You can't quit. You're a frog. You can't frog me. You're my wife.
I'm not your wife, you're my wife.
Oh, shit. Then who's flying the plane?
We're getting our references crossed.
Not okay with it.
Anyway, who's next?
I don't know. I've lost track. Let's say Geralt can be next. Unless he's still brooding.
I don't know. The offhanded comment of like, I've only known you for a few days made me bring back up my little timeline chart.
Oh.
And
so, I probably got
the wrong. Yeah. Right.
It's been about 10 days since Zayn joined us.
Okay. That's it. Only?
So a week.
Yep.
Whoa.
A little over a week. Okay.
Welcome to the party. How's your... Oh, God.
It feels like it's been so much longer than that.
Well,
in Dragon time, that is basically 2 days.
Yeah.
Yeah, in Medicaid time, that's like an hour.
If we're close to the border of respite, then it's like day 18.
Yeah, 18 or 19.
Give it up for day 18.
Yay.
Yeah, Geralt will walk up to Zaradon.
Geralt on.
Mm-hmm. Hey,
dynamic we haven't seen much.
I wanted to sort of check in and apologize. I, when we got into... Why can't I think of tenants? When we got to St. Cordia, I did not necessarily approve of the tactics he used getting into town, but I was kind of acting under the impression of trying to gain allies, and I went along with trying to get in and talk things out peacefully with them. And upon entering that courtroom and realizing they really had no intention of being fair or seeing reason, I feel like I let eyes down.
The information that was presented at the time, it was a fair call.
Yeah, I just... Leaving that town, realizing I probably should have, I don't know, approached things differently. I was blinded by, I don't know, trying to walk in there with moneyed words and evidence, thinking that we could talk to the unreasonable and find peace that way, but I just learned I need to...
Well, it's useful to have people with that optimism in a war band.
Yes. Yeah. But I say I respect your decision on the bridge there, and I appreciate that you're looking out for us. And I'm sorry I wasn't able to defend eyes. But I hope that we can meet up with them soon, but I hope that we can work together and, I don't know, be there for the group through all this, both tactically and, I don't know. I'm just sort of going around checking in, trying to gather my thoughts on what to do. But thank you for what you did in Sancordia.
No worries. I'm at your command.
Alright. And I'll just kind of keep making rounds.
Interesting. Yep.
And Zeradon's a quiet one, so I'm always curious about his internal monologue.
I love opinions. It. Always nice.
You don't have to worry about. You don't have to wonder about Zayn's opinions. He'll tell you.
Yes, Zayn will walk up to you, punch you in the stomach, and say, "I love you," and then walk away.
It feels so different. Different because, like, Ringo and Zayn wear their hearts on their sleeves. Mm-hmm. Ness is the middle ground, and then Phoenix and Zaradon have this kind of, like, if I tell you too much, I feel like I'm gonna let go of a part of myself. I'm starting
to... Geralt, like,
yeah, Geralt is also slightly in the middle ground, I feel. Yeah. We have a two-two-two-two-ish kind of thing.
Yeah. There you go.
Two by two, but
yeah.
Even spread. Even spread.
Yay.
Like a sandwich.
Ringo, you don't wear your heart on your sleeve. Like your tattoo is on your is your sleeve. Me. Sure.
You want to talk about your feelings, Eric? No.
No.
I do. I know. I'm sad. I know.
I know.
I know. I feel like that is, like, the conversation of, like, either Zayn or Ringo with Phoenix.
Yep. We need that. We need that one squish. That's one of the videos you can make.
Wait. Okay, so we'll have to send it to me.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I got you.
All right. There is a thing I want to do, but I need to gather my thoughts. Bleh, my brain stopped working. Of course my brain always stops working.
No.
Yeah.
It's always the thing, it's like you plan things out, and it's like, alright, I'm ready, and then you get in the session, it's like...
And then we get here, and it's like, oh.
It's okay, I didn't have anything planned. I wasn't fucking expecting to have a chance!
alright, I guess I would approach Zayn.
Kilo.
Why am I putting on the accent? I'm not saying.
Scatter animals, scatter!
Force a habit.
It's contagious.
It's contagious.
I just wanted to say that I do appreciate how you go your way to ensure my safety. Both back in the valley with that sorcerer and in Sancordia when you insisted I call for help if I got into any trouble. But I don't need people stretching their necks out for me like that. Really, I'll be okay on my own.
That's our job, is it not?
I mean, sure, but really, I'm fine. I've chosen to fight for my homeland, which means I've chosen to die for it as well. I have accepted that, and I don't need people falling in my stead. Especially since you put yourself in a difficult spot with that mage in the valley the other day, and I would not forgive myself if someone was to try to protect me and then fell. I would not forgive myself.
It's kind of a backwards way to show gratitude, but it's alright.
I know, but... And I do appreciate it, but I don't need that. Really.
Too bad.
Okay.
Too bad, fuck you. You get love and attention.
Okay. Nessa's perplexed. She has this look on her face.
You become perplexa.
Perplexa. Oh god, that'd be such a cool fantasy name though.
Zane's like, all right.
Perplexa, play Wonderwall.
No.
Why am I singing? I wouldn't sing with a flute.
Play some Weezer.
Don't make me wheeze at you.
Okay. So, Nessa would be perplexed, but she would kind of just raise her voice a little bit. Like, listen, I never meant to make a huge deal out of the chivalry you showed me. I do appreciate it, and I should have been thankful first and foremost. I am really sorry for not being more polite, but have you considered that some people are fine with laying down their lives for something? For some, their purpose to a cause is sacrifice because they might not have anything else to live for. Maybe so someone of actual value gets to see another day instead. So, I do appreciate it, but please, I've got my own back, it's fine.
Eh, like I said, too bad. you have worth too, you know.
That's a nice thought, and then Nessa just walks off. Oh,
okay.
Alright, just pushed yourself between us. Alright.
Yep. Yeah. And she's seething. Well, she's not seething, but she's kind of... I don't want to say brooding. There's already, like, two brooders in this fucking...
More people can brood.
She's not a knight. She can pout.
Yeah, that's a mirror.
Ah, yes. A mirror. This
is get a little silly.
I see your opinion, but I have my opinion.
I understand you have your opinion. Also, fuck you, eh?
I'm not calling you weak. I'm just saying I do not want you to die.
We are a group. We have each other's backs. It's fine you have your own. We will also watch it.
Basically,
did you say Nessa was yelling that last part?
Yes.
Cool.
Well, she raised her voice. I don't know if it was yelling.
Oh.
I guess.
Okay.
But she did stand back to say it. I don't know.
What would you DM, would you say this area is small enough that it doesn't matter? As far as, like, it is, a raised voice is loud enough.
It is pretty much an encampment. You're all within earshot, essentially.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You have private conversations if you're of talking volume, but the minute you raise your voice, pretty much the whole camp's gonna hear you.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking.
You did probably also just push your way between Ringo and Phoenix as they were just kind of tidily chit-chatting.
That's a fair point. I didn't see the path I went. I just kind of moved my token and went. You know what? That is fair.
Both of them.
Oh.
Oh. Yeah. I don't know what happened there.
I do. It was pretty cool.
Wasn't that great, Kubitha?
Don't look at me.
Yay, bring back Kubitha.
Kubitha's back.
I am Kubitha Prime. Anyway,
Kubitha Prime.
Kubius.
We have Kubius values here in Fallen Kingdom.
Valorant?
Valorant?
Valorant? The Riot game?
And apparently we also have a stroke every 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of us will be able to talk, we just don't know who.
I'm gonna tell you, it ain't me, Chief.
Probably, Not me. Probably Vulcan, honestly.
Yeah, it's likely Vulcan.
Speaking of, do you want to do anything, Phoenix? No.
Oh no.
Kill him.
Apprehension.
Agony.
Yeah, so I'm sorry if this isn't a good time. I just wanted it, like, you seem a little upset.
Hi. Yeah, yes. It's fine. Yeah, everything's fine.
Are you sure?
Ah. finding words. You know what? No, that's what you say, nothing.
Okay. Well, if you
need to beat up a dragon.
if you do need to offload your mind, I am here for you.
Thank you.
All right, then, what do I want to do?
What can I make for? Any inspiration? Going into your tent.
Yeah, I think so.
Exploding.
Mental images of exploding in the book that she'd shared. Yes.
Yeah, that's it. let's see if I can read something in this freaking journal.
All right.
Oh, boy.
Daily journal roll.
You're not a knight, so you can't brood, so I guess you're, being edgy?
I'm contemplating.
Yeah, there you go.
Technically, she could brood. She's a bird.
Oh, that's true. But that would have a different implication. That would mean she's reproduced somehow.
No!
Do not lay an egg in there!
Yeah, I was about to say that. That means she would have laid an egg.
Just Zach's message. I'm like, yeah, same.
Sometimes wish we had face cam on.
No, I don't.
I don't.
That'd be great.
The internet does not need that from me.
I would disappear from cam like 80% of the time with how I lay.
Oh.
All right. What do you, yeah, so just random reading in the journal, I guess. Not necessarily looking for anything in particular. What do you want me to roll?
Intelligence.
All right.
Don't you just love when the DM goes,
Yeah.
That's not concerning.
You do what you want, man. I'll just roleplay it with you.
That would be a success. I have a 48 in intelligence.
Okay, so you're just opening random pages, huh?
Yeah.
A treatise for resurrecting the dead.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Segway.
Okay.
Guys, we have to go back to coma now.
Yay!
But
no!
There's perfectly good dragon skeletons right here.
Oh.
Why would we start with the dragon?
To resurrect a dragon that's been dead forever.
Who's the dragon? What the fuck,
I'm sure nothing bad will happen.
Unironically, it wouldn't be the first time in a Fire Emblem game that this has happened.
Yeah.
Just immediately. Wait a minute, where'd my 100 gold go?
Experiment, because if it turns hostile, it would be easier to kill.
Who took my money?
You know, panicking more.
A treatise on resurrecting the dead. Please keep in mind that this should only be done in the most dire of circumstances, as the requirements for doing so greatly outweigh the end result. It lists a number of ingredients, some of which you recognize are very difficult to find, like nightshade that only grows in a specific part of the world, for example. Blood of a dragon, not a manakeet, in several underlined notes.
Damn it. Oh, Zayn, your blood. What?
Zayn, what?
The soul Zayn, of the
hold
deceased.
Still.
The soul of the deceased and half of your own.
Oh.
Whoa.
Fucking disconnect.
Yep.
They've hurt.
Yeah, it's just not disconnected us yet.
It will,
yeah,
don't worry.
Yeah, it will.
Me
I'm currently trying to connect to the player. Among others.
God. I'm still here. Oh, I'm still here. Me. No.
No. I almost quit the game by accident. Let's not do that.
Anything else in the thing?
The map should be back up, by the way. I don't know if it'll show it to you on Steam yet.
It's showing me. Let's hop in. And not it also, choose the wrong color.
The treatise also, you know, gives the incantation, you know, the words that you need to say and such. What once was flesh, what once was mine, return to dust, return to time. To breathe new life in what once was, I bid ye rise, return to me.
Give me dungeon meshy vibes.
Ooh.
Yeah, it does. I have to bounce also. I had been to actually barely.
Boing, boing, boing. Well, we can just say that Ringo retired.
Boingy, boingy.
Yeah, but Ringo said you can talk to Ringo's mom, just no luck talking to Ringo now.
she's brooding.
Okay. No, she's not brooding. She just took a nap and actually
fell asleep. Fucking nap.
Everyone will be brooding.
Cats do, not cats all do sleep up to like 20 hours a day.
Yeah. So it's cool. It's all good. But yeah, I'll talk to you later.
Later. Have fun.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. We're ready.
Apart from that, there's, you know, other requirements, I suppose, you know, details how to extract part of one's own soul for the whole thing.
Yeah, I was kind of wondering that part. It's like you need the soul.
I've seen a glitch.
What happened?
The table is an EXP calculator.
Oh, yep, it sure is.
Oh, it is.
Hang on.
The world has become.
Oh.
We hadn't seen that in ages. Well spotted, Zach.
Yeah. I usually play Freeze and Dent, so.
Yeah, same.
Is it fixed?
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's have a look.
Yes.
Yes.
Off topic, is today session 21 or 22?
23. The process of extracting one's soul is not one for the faint of heart. You yourself have to be near death to accomplish it in the first place. Mm-hmm. You know that saying, to give up the ghost? It's more accurate than you think it is.
Oh, okay.
That's cute.
Oh.
When you yourself are on the brink of death, you must act a ritual to capture your own soul. You need a container, firstly. Any container will do, I have found. And you need to do the incantation as listed below. To betray time, to betray doom, into my soul, enact this tomb. Apparently you need a very, very high magical prowess to be able to do this also. Doing so means that you yourself, even though you should have died, will not. Your soul will be trapped and contained in whatever vessel you so choose. Your body, however, best not to get into the details of that one.
Ooh.
Oh.
There is a footnote at the very bottom of this page. There is a footnote at the bottom of this page, written in blood.
Oh.
Two words. It works.
Oh.
Oh, God. Okay.
All right.
Very nice.
I'm very diligently writing this down.
Guys, I love writing horror. Can I just say?
You're so good at it.
Mm-hmm. Oh man, every time I love these Phoenix Journal moments.
Alright, so I'm gonna need some help to enacting this. I'm kidding.
So if someone ever dies and you have a magic over 25.
Alright, magic over 20, got it.
No, I'm joking.
Got it. I need somebody to damage me.
Quick, someone can- wait, hang on. How much?
Zayn, punch me in the face!
Okay base magic of a 25. How about that, fucker?
Base magic of 25?
Sure.
I was talking about already... like the near death thing.
Oh, that too. How are you gonna get there if we have survival instinct?
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like it's gonna be so hard to get me there.
But you get plus six to all your stats, so that would actually bring you pretty close to the magic requirement.
Right.
Oh god.
I would need 19 minimum magic before survival instinct can get me to the minimum of 25, but you know.
Yeah.
That's insane.
That's not that too unreasonable.
Yeah, that's not too unreasonable at all.
Yeah. Now the question of whether or not you would is a different story.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially since, like, you mentioned needing, like, the soul of the deceased as well.
Yeah, the soul of the deceased and half of your own.
Jeez.
A lot. Ugh. Strike two souls. Ugh.
Well, I guess I will shove that into my back pocket.
In case we ever need to revive the dead using your own soul.
Oh my god.
Like Phoenix just found a little, literally like those old cheat code books, but for real life.
Oh my fucking god.
The question being, is the resurrection really living?
Oh, that's a good question too. Woof.
I have so many dumbass questions about this, but I'll wait until after session because they're not relevant.
E, and might I add, he.
Please place the soul into a Ziploc bag.
I did specify that literally any container works.
Yeah.
Yep.
So long as it can be sealed, it works.
I was about to say, shot glass.
I mean, shot glass and a lid, sure.
Yeah, if you have a small enough lid for the shot glass, I guess.
Yeah.
Now I'm picturing a soul just in a Tupperware.
In a Tupperware?
Just kind of floating there. It's indestructible enough, I guess that'd work.
Yeah.
You open the fridge and it's like, okay, there's casserole, my soul, lasagna.
Dead pigeon, do not eat.
Dead dove.
Oh, is it dove? My bad.
Yeah.
What did you want me to say? Cat dead? Details later? That's a reanimator reference for you. I don't know if anyone's seen that.
Yep, I have.
Oh, good.
Great movie.
That movie freaked me the fuck out. There's very few films that do that for me, but Reanimator is one of them. Open forum. I'm going to give you guys all one more round each before something happens.
Oh.
I mean, I could also just have the NPCs do something. That could be something to do.
Yeah, we should probably take the opportunity to talk to NPCs as well.
Yeah.
We have a whole party of them.
That was a thought I had. It's just like, I don't know how to start any conversations with any of these people right now.
So how's the weather?
So how's the weather? My God.
Do you have $20 I could borrow?
No, we're all on a budget. Our payroll's in jail.
Winter is coming. You. Do you have your coat?
Ringo's got the money. I heard Ringo just had 100 gold.
Still have most of the winnings from the tournament.
Hey.
135.
Unless we just want the plot to just progress like now.
I guess I have a couple of things I could do before until we move on, if that's all right.
Yay! Go ahead.
All right. Well, first off, I'm gonna go approach Jimmy and Zara.
As you should.
I should. Hey, I just wanted to check in. How did the rest of the guard do at the church back in Sancordia?
Well, it was a pretty uneventful way to gain some cash. Nothing really happened. Jamie pipes up.
Ah. Weird. Okay. what that
was. Does make me wonder, though, what they were wanting to guard.
Yeah. Especially with, you know, what happened. Intriguing.
Zara's just been having, like, her eyes on, like, the, on the horizon for the entirety of this, like, trip so far.
Aww.
He looks nervous.
I guess I would gently tap her shoulder. What you looking at?
Oh, sorry. Nothing. Just something familiar about all this.
I see. Well, if you need anything. Oh?
I'm gonna see if she can remember.
Oh. Ooh.
Well. There's something familiar about all this.
Oh.
Why is Zara all the way over there? Go back where you're supposed to be. On the fucking character list.
Oh.
Oh.
It's like, she hasn't moved.
No, she hasn't moved on the screen, but she's moved on mine.
Is there anything I can do to jog her memory, maybe?
Ooh, that's a fun question. What do you want to try to do? Barter with her memory? I don't know.
Barter with her memory?
I don't know. You tell me. You're the player here. I'll just say whatever your plan is. It's cool.
Okay, can I... Good question. I didn't think this far ahead.
I don't know. I didn't think I'd get this far.
I guess I'm in the middle of a fucking desert. I'll pray for a sign.
You're gonna pray for a sign.
Yeah. I don't
before
know.
Work before.
I'll look to the horizon, and yeah, I'll look to the horizon. I'll clasp my hands together. I'll pray to Ashanira, thanking her first and foremost for the warning, even if I don't know what the fuck it was for. And then as I'm looking on at the horizon, I think, is there anything I can do for my friend?
Aww. Your barter check, actually, yeah.
Barter? Oh, okay.
You're bartering with your faith.
My barter is shit.
So your faith is shit, that tracks.
Yeah.
Oh, 30, that's not bad.
My barter is a fucking 17, so...
Ah.
No.
Right, everyone's dump stat, bartering.
Not mine.
Okay.
Mine's 60.
Which ironically makes you the most religious, technically speaking.
Oh.
In certain ways of thinking, yes. That's a very Ferengi way of thinking about fucking religion. It's like you're bartering with your faith.
Funny, religion in 5e is an intelligence stat.
Is it? Oh, that's fun. You'd think it's wisdom, because you're just putting your faith blindly in something. I don't know.
Well, the religion stat in 5e is like, what can you recall about the physical teachings of this religion? If you're praying, I think it's wisdom.
Oh, that makes sense.
Ah.
Because clerics are a wisdom caster.
Not to self, figure out faith.
Yeah. Well, I guess I would walk off, and then I just say, if you need anything, Sarah, let me know. Maybe I can help further.
Yeah. You kind of looked where she was looking, and you thought you saw something for a minute, but you don't.
Okay. And I guess I'd quickly approach Geralt, actually, as well. If that's alright, I don't want to overstay.
Yeah, well, we're just doing whatever. This is a we're here to roleplay.
Hey, Zayn was questioning your authority. Being a snitch, JK.
No. I would approach Geralt and be like, sir, can I talk to you about something in private? It's in regards to something I just knew about me, but I feel like it would be a courtesy for you to know.
Okay.
Not out here. We would probably, I'd usher him away somewhere away from everyone else.
Yeah, just go to the outskirts of camp or go into a tent.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know where we're going. There we go. Riverside.
Alberation's on Alberation World Tour. No.
Oh, we got there.
All right. So, sir, this is strange to just blurt out. It almost feels quite pretentious, actually. It's about Alboretian politics and those involved. How much do you know about the politics of our country?
God damn it.
Something
tells me he's going to ask me now.
I'm sorry.
I feel like have I heard of the Broderick's?
You would have a solid grasp on the nobles and just like generally who's who of Alboretian nobility. How about that?
Yeah, I know the important people. I know who I get my orders from, but roughly, yeah.
Okay, I just wanted to mention that my father, Alistair Broderick, he's a noble involved in politics up in Tyke Sector. At least he was. We don't have much of a title about a country after all. So that would mean back up north I was loosely involved in formal spaces as well. I'm telling you because I was originally hesitant to tell anyone for a variety of reasons, but I'll admit the recent events in San Cordia have made me feel guilty regarding my former position. I feel as if my political knowledge, my political knowledge isn't perfect since the war hit before I was old enough to really get involved in it. And I'm not the inspiring politician type anyway, but maybe speaking up sooner about that position could have been the difference between having eyes of us and our current outcome. I should have said something from day one, or at least when you were being summoned to the castle. And I do feel like an idiot for withholding that information in an emergency. I'm sorry.
It chuckles a little bit. It's I honestly don't know if it would have changed much. They were dead set, it seemed, in their ways. We gave them evidence and they twisted it back around at us. I don't know. It's a rough situation, but honestly, with us being able to walk away, able to be, free to do what we need to do, that's not the best we could have asked for, but that's not walking away with nothing. We can make it right, and we will get eyes back to us, but I do appreciate the sentiment, but I don't know if they would have listened. We showed them the journal and everything, and told them about the cults and all the good things that we did, and they spun it around that like we rescued Zara. They spun that we were aiding them.
I'm sorry, what? They did?
Yeah. Yes. There was no reasoning with them. They just wanted us gone. Someone to blame.
That's gods. I don't know why I'm surprised. Some governments are like that. I can't believe that. And we kind of look over at Zara's tent and just be like,
Yeah.
Wow.
I don't know. I feel like I gave up too much information. We kind of had them for a bit, but I think maybe mentioning Zero is what pushed it too far.
Don't blame yourself. I mean, you had evidence and you shared it. It was on, from the signs of things, it was on them for twisting your words.
Yeah. Hello. We're just we've lost. Not lost. Zayn, not Zayn. Names are flying around my head. Eyes and locks. I don't know. Words are not working.
Whatever.
Going through this. I don't know. We keep losing good Alberic folk on our journey, and I'd want to stop that. lost Ark. Now we're without Eyes and Locke. And I just want to make sure. I don't know.
Yeah.
I want to keep the core of this group and our mission on point. Like, this is a fight for our people. And since Zayn probably had some hesitation about leadership decisions, but
oh,
I don't know. I want raises an eyebrow. I don't know. This is a fight for our people, and I want to do my country right. And wrestling with the fact that things haven't gone great for us in the past few days, and I want to make sure we can bounce back. But no. This was my duty to protect Albrecht once, and I failed. And this is my chance to do it again. And I feel like I let down Eyes at the courtroom, but I can't lose this chance. This is my one shot at reclaiming my home. And I will make sure as many people from Albrecht get to see the sunrise in their home once more.
That's what put a hand on his. What were you going to say?
I wouldn't say he's on his. She just stares across the oasis lake we're at.
Yeah. Like a cliff?
Yeah.
Cliff.
Water.
Yeah.
Nessa put a hand on his. Are you on a horse right now?
Nah, I'd be off of this horse right now. Probably walking alongside Riz.
Yeah. Okay. Nessa put a hand on his shoulder. You didn't fail. And believe me, this has come from someone who also... I mean, not also. This has come from someone who did. You fought for our country back when things were at its most bleak. And I thank you so much for your service. Even if the outcome wasn't what we anticipated, you all fought so hard. You, my father, a lot of Albaritians fought, returned, died for that war, and whether we won or not, you're not a failure. You didn't fail. Your service is greatly appreciated here, then, and now. We will reclaim Albrecht together. I promise you that.
Yes. Nods and gives a smile. But well, here's hoping we can turn things around.
Yes.
But we'll hope that this lead with Tatum grants us some more allies. So.
Of course. Eyes and Locke will catch up with us. It won't all be for naught.
Yeah. Oh, granted, I didn't see Locke in the courtroom.
Really?
Hmm.
I didn't hear about his arrest until after I got into the city. I was with the Mercenary Guild, so I didn't even
hear
that he got arrested until I crossed the bridge.
He threw up a little bit of a defiant stance to the guards right in front of us, so...
I mean, yeah.
Yeah, it was an interesting move. I don't know. The fact he wasn't there, either he was arrested, or he was put in prison because he didn't need to be at the meeting, but Eyes was there. He was there for the whole defense. But yeah, Eyes, bleh. Locke was nowhere to be seen.
I mean, Locke is quite blunt, but I've never considered him the type to do that. kind of thing. Not to mention, wouldn't he also have been at the... It's a bit weird that he also wasn't at the court hearing with Eyes, yes. Considering he's literally Eyes' right-hand man, from what I gather.
Yes. So, more things to think about. But...
Yep, just another mystery onto the pile, I guess.
Well, about what I said with them blaming or grouping Zaradon with the cult, don't tell her. She's got enough on her hands. I don't want her to think, I don't want her to worry about a government labeling her.
Oh, of course not. Your secret's safe with me. In fact, I've been looking into approaching Phoenix about finding some sort of way to help her since Calma. But then things got so crazy, I hadn't gotten around to doing it. I figured if there was any way to help her, it would be in that journal she's carrying.
So just like a nervous chuckle. It's like, I don't know. I'm wary of that journal, but if some good can come from it, maybe.
I mean,
well, that's anyone, my opinion.
That is understandable. If anyone has a handle on anything magical, I would say it's Phoenix.
And that's a fair point. I'm not in any means knowledgeable of magic, so.
Oh, God, neither
am I. It just makes me nervous.
My extent of magic is musical. The extent of my magic is a musical placebo. Let's put it that way.
I see. Yeah, no, I like sticking with physical weapons that I can tangibly, you know, get the hang of. All this magic stuff confuses the hell out of me.
It is beyond me as well. But my brother has healing, can heal, but beyond that, I don't know anything. Either.
Sure. Well, thanks for checking in, Nessa. I'm going to continue, I guess, just patrolling. I don't know what else to do with myself right now.
And I'd appreciate if you kept that nobility stuff under wraps. I do eventually plan on telling the others, especially before we reach the Northern Territories, but like I said, I have my reasons for keeping it to myself. Which is part of the reason I blew up at Zayn, actually, but I'll not get into that.
Okay.
But that's
not my secret to share, so it's all good.
Thank you. All right.
Mm-hmm. Continue patrol.
Yeah, you be.
And she's just gonna vibe here.
And you vibe.
I had a thought.
I have a lot of those. That's
yeah. Awesome. About what time would you say it is in universe?
Sun's starting to set.
Alright. Then I think I want to collect some wood to gather up a campfire.
Hey.
Hell yeah.
Well, you got some palm trees.
Yeah, that's...
Oh,
yeah.
Haven't really thought about this. Give me, like... You know what? I'm gonna ask you, what characteristic or combat stat do you think you're gonna be using to gather firewood?
Oh god, that's a good question.
What's your axe rank?
Well, it's zero.
You wanna pull a Minecraft and have Zayn punch the trees?
Okay, I will just kind of as a brief D&D aside here. A zero in a stat does not mean that you are a fucking moron when it comes to wielding that weapon.
Oh, yeah,
like,
I know.
You have a general idea of how it works. So it's very likely you've used an axe before to chop down a tree.
Or like wood cutting, sure. Well, I mean, has Phoenix done it though?
Yeah, exactly. If you've done it or not, that's, you know, another story, but you get the general concept of how axe to tree.
I feel like what she would do is she would just try to gather like small branches.
Oh, okay. So like, and, like just palm fronds that have fallen or dried out.
Yeah, so like stuff that's easy to like get burning to start the fire, and then somebody else can get like the bigger thing.
Yeah, fuck it. Give me a perception check then.
All right.
Zane hasn't worked a day in his life.
Well, I mean,
effort now, but you know,
fighting.
I am blind.
Yeah. Are you blind? You know what? I'm not gonna be mean to you. I'll say that you get the most obvious pieces of tinder, but probably overlook some stuff that would be better.
Okay, that makes sense.
Like, I'm not gonna have you like go to a field of palm fronds and palm trees and be like, "Wow, there's nothing here." And
yeah, there's nothing here.
Wow.
Do you see the palm tree?
Do you see the palm tree? Nope. Leaves. Turns your TV off. You're not learning Spanish today with Dora.
No. All right,
I don't remember what tree is in Spanish.
Árbol.
Ah, well, actually.
Árbol, yes. Yeah, I did know that.
Yeah, like Arbor Day. Like
Arbor Day, yeah.
They got, Zayn, I'm gonna start setting up for a fire. You want to get some like more substantial wood to keep it going?
Sure.
You return to the land of trees and palms.
Zane's a city boy, so.
What's your game plan?
Pull street out of ground.
Tree out of ground.
Juice tree. Tree.
Neither of those things will work.
Let's see. I mean, the only thing he has is greaves and a shield.
Kicks down a tree.
Tree with greaves.
Throw. Baby, at tree.
I mean, so his prosthetic is kind of claw like on the end. Do you think he could maybe pry off like bark with it?
Okay, give me a strength check.
Okay,
that sounds cool. So this is just gonna be like a d20.
Okay.
If you roll within your strength, it's a success. If you roll within your base, it's a double success.
My strength is 15. Oh, I just missed it.
You rolled a stat. Well, using your prosthetic isn't gonna work.
Okay. Would I notice these two having trouble getting wood?
Geralt, see that?
My normal hand.
Yeah, let's try your normal hand. Give me another strength check this time, buddy.
That's within my base.
There you go. Not only do you get some dried off bark from the palm tree, it kind of like, you get like a lot enough to make a fire with.
Okay.
Zane's just like, ugh, my nails are dirty now.
Oh.
I hate this prissy city boy so much.
City boy.
I need this. Anyway, I'm gonna keep that thought to myself.
I need this twink obliterated.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Yeah. Sure.
Here is wood.
You build a fire.
Yes. Right. Right there is where I want the fire. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. Now, if you excuse me, I had to clean my nails now.
Okay.
I made it darker.
His little kit.
Whoa.
Manicure Furry Phoenix, kit. I think it's getting dark.
Hey, it's my manicure kit.
Cute manicure.
Oh, I like the shadows. Attachment
on yeah, his I oh, love the you. Shadows.
Of Valencia? Yeah, it's a good game.
It is a great game. Too bad it's hard as balls.
Greenhorn, what was
Lol.
Okay, that was a brain thought, not a word thought. I shouldn't have said it out loud. Also, word thought, alright.
Also, by the way, fuck the Tinder, it was magic.
Yeah, no, exactly.
Magic.
Look at this beautiful little moment we're having.
Yeah, this is cool. It's very pretty.
Album art for Xenoblade 3.
I always think of the part of Final Fantasy X at the very beginning where it's like the piano is coming in and you see everybody at the fucking fire. And then Tita's like puts his hands on you and she's all like, oh. And then he goes to brood. A lot of brooding this session.
What's brooding?
I mean, with what we went through.
Ding, ding, ding.
We earned this brooding.
Ding, ding, ding.
I was gonna flavor it. If Zayn failed the check with his real hand, that he would have broken nail and been pissed.
God damn it.
It's interesting you bring that up, Zach. He posted something in the VC chat. I was like, I always imagined that some stuff Zaradon would be doing post waking up amnesia would be doing some lumber working. That's not out of character for a lot of Fire Emblem Axemen, just to be like random woodcutters and lumberjacks and stuff before going to the party.
I always imagine he basically woke up in a forest and was just kind of working in the woods for a while.
I know that's who I am.
That's kind of how he grounded himself, was just working with woods, taking care of bandits out there, just kind of being the random knight in the woods sort of thing. Until he got the letter, so.
As night falls, and as you, cook up whatever rations you guys happen to have, I assume that you brought, food or are able to hunt for stuff.
Yeah.
You hear the distant sound of hoofbeats.
Oh, Lord.
Huh?
What is it this time?
Oh, boy.
Horses, specifically. As if any other creature makes hoofbeats, I guess.
Yeah, just horses, though.
Tempe!
There are many hoofed animals.
You see a lone man marching through the desert with a convoy of horses.
Oh.
And he just kind of silently approaches your encampment. Who's the leader around here?
Geralt.
Or one turns to Geralt.
Yeah, everyone's talking mad shit until someone actually has to be a leader.
Everyone, it was Zayn. Okay.
Points at the fucking mannequin. Him. Well,
that would be me.
Is this a blockade or are we able to move through?
We're just passing. We're set up camp right now. I'm not a blockade or anything. Association.
I see. I'm looking for a map. You
were?
You could assist me. Oh, sorry. Did you have
say
a question? We kind of both asked the question.
What did you say?
I'm looking for a man, if you could assist me.
May I ask who?
You may.
Who are you?
What a dick.
I mean, usually people just answer the who question rather than
you may. Me.
This guy's a dick. The fuck?
Who are you looking for?
Weird enough, fellow about your height, brown hair, has a beard, last name Cinta?
Oh, good grief. Yes, that'd be me.
Good. My instincts haven't failed me yet. He hands you a letter.
Thank you.
You would recognize it as the same one that print signer of Alberic would have sent out.
Finally, some good luck.
I understand you're the man in charge of the convoy now.
Be correct.
Well, sorry to say, but your position's been filled. And he just kind of pushes you aside.
What?
Huh?
Right then.
What?
Huh?
Huh.
I understand it that you've met my employer, Prince Signer of Alberic. Let me introduce myself. My name is Kanan. I am a businessman by trade. I know you probably are thinking loads of questions, but I don't care about any of them at the moment. What I care about is making sure that this army is financed, well-equipped, and taken care of.
I had some objections, but I no longer have any.
You may now ask questions.
Okay.
How well-equipped?
Let's just say I want to make sure that if your weapons break, you have replacements. If your teeth get gnashed down to dust, that you have something to eat with, and if you need healing, that you are supplied in that regard.
Oh, nice.
This I like.
Okay, then, so you're Kanan, alright.
That would be me, aye.
Well...
He just kind of hold his hand out for you. He's like, apologies, I'm not good at introductions. I am good at making business.
Clearly. Well, I guess if you seem to have things sorted out, what's our step from here then? We were told to meet you in Respite.
Well, Respite is about half a day's journey away, so you picked a decent spot to camp up.
Right.
Been on the block a few times. You human types tend to think with money rather than your brains, so that's the sort of business that I took up myself.
I don't know if we can squint any further.
Yeah, like, squint further.
This man is squinting so hard that his eyelids are touching.
His eyes are closed. Well, money is powerful language.
Indeed.
Now, and it is one of my languages.
Now, if you do need me as a combatant, I will warn you, I'm not exactly amazing in terms of combat. I am trained in arts that some might find unnatural, but they serve me well enough. And whenever I attack, people tend to be a little perplexed. So.
Can I point out something?
You may.
You're saying Respite was to the west.
Yes.
Yeah, he came in from behind.
He came in from the east, where we came from.
Correct.
Huh?
Yeah, so, this gentleman just kind of comes out of the blue and says, oh yeah, I'm going to be your new source of supply and logistics. Out of the blue.
I like
right after we left, an entire country pissed off.
I like your skepticism. Love it. Honestly... can't do without it.
Does Fine. The seal on the letter seem up and up?
Oh, yeah. It looks pretty much identical to the letter that you received.
Okay.
Tell you what. To prove that I am who indeed I say I am, I can introduce you to somebody very powerful and very important. If you, you know, care about entertaining the idea of royalty being in charge, you... He's kind of like waves his hand in the air.
And who do you have in mind?
A princess.
Oh?
Does this princess have a name?
May.
What is her name?
Sometimes you just have to have an asshole in
there. Go sleep. Violently
next
to him. Well, she goes by Frigga these days, so, you know, keep that on the hush-hush, but Princess Yesenia of Alberic is a couple of days away.
I've heard that.
She'll be arriving in Respite soon.
I've heard that name before as well.
Hold the phone. He's like patting his robes and like looking through things like which one of you is Zaradon again?
Me.
Letter for you, sir. And he passes you a single piece of paper.
What? What? Who even knows I exist?
Well, it's addressed from a Gabriel Lockheed. I don't know if that tells you anything.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Alright, so what does the letter say?
Letter says, I'll be brief. Meet in Garros Cove. Something's afoot in Bornai. Poeira involved. Details later.
Alright.
Ooh.
I have no idea where the hell Garros...
Garros Cove? It's over here.
Cove. Yeah, okay, well...
Like in the middle of the country.
I guess we have our heading once we get everything else situated.
Mm-hmm. Bornai is kind of open territory. There's lots of paths going everywhere you need to go. But I don't have a set plan in mind for any of you guys. You guys can decide to go wherever you so please. It's not as linear as, say, I don't know, going in a straight line as Poeira was.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that makes sense since it was the first chapter.
Yeah.
The world is a lot more open now.
Yeah. We've got our bearings. We can sandbox mode.
Yeah.
Yay.
We got out of the tutorial.
Mm-hmm.
The tutorial country.
God, I feel like I'm forgetting something else. Oh, yes, I do have a letter addressed to a Miss Ringo, but it does not appear she is here next time, when she's awake. What else? Now, I know I'm asking a lot of you to just, you know, up and trust me out of the blue, so if you need money, I have money, but...
I like money.
He likes money. The man likes money. Go fucking figure.
Go fucking figure, the dragon likes money.
But, I wouldn't be too ecstatic upon seeing the princess personally. She can be a little, what's the term? Strict? Rigid? Hard to trust?
Hard to trust?
Really?
No, the other way around. She finds it difficult to trust others.
There you go.
That's
not terribly
unfair. I fully understand that.
I guess the only other thing you'd notice about this guy is he is dressed in, like, full, like, Alberician ecclesiarchy, like, garb. Like, this guy looks like a man of the cloth of the Church of Alberic.
Would I recognize him from anywhere?
Great question. Give me a perception check.
All right.
What's that? Can I do that as well?
You may.
Is he important enough?
Damn it!
No.
Idiot.
Wait, what was this check?
Perception.
You're trying to perceive things about Kanan.
No. Nope.
Well, you can definitely recognize what he's wearing.
And it
Ooh,
looks
I love
cool.
your brand. You know, this guy was originally going to be a diviner, but then I was like, nah, he's a sorcerer now.
Nice.
Neat.
Yeah, to balance it up.
Yeah, you gotta balance up the kinds of magic we have.
So you hail from Alberic as well?
No.
No?
No.
Oh?
I am simply partial to your cause.
Gotcha.
And, let's just say that as far as governments go, you have a pretty decent idea.
Gotcha.
I can't argue with that.
Right.
Alberic was a dear neighbor to us.
He like raises an eyebrow. Indeed. So I assume you've had something to eat. Shall I get us something to prep your bellies? What? I'm at your command.
Any alcohol?
His shoulders just kind of slump, and he's like, just looking at you half-lidded, like, "Come on, dude."
Uh,
Do you have like a stock of weaponry?
Yes we do. It's pretty much the basics and what I could afford on such short notice, but we do have a cache of weapons available. It's basically your just bronze tier stuff.
Okay.
Mm. Okay.
In case all your shit breaks.
Yeah. Pretty much, essentially,
That makes sense.
Which is to say, one of each of the bronze tier stuff. Which reminds me. Take a look at the Discord really quick.
Oh, okay.
We have a convoy now. Or wait, hang on. Nope, it's not letting me edit it. One second.
It asked me to request access when it
gets
back to.
Yep, I noticed that as soon as I noticed it.
Yay, another spreadsheet for the collection.
Click the share
button.
Another
hand touches the beacon.
A new hand touches the beacon.
A new That's hand touches my penis.
No.
Okay, sorry.
Wait, why did I have to say no?
There we go. No, it's
interesting.
Sure.
No, I
will be adding the weapons in a minute, but just for a frame of reference, assume that there is one of each of the lowest Eve rank thing, your bronze stuff, in the convoy there.
Okay.
Nice. Cool.
There's also, like, three vulneraries in the item section.
Okay.
Now, if only we had a ship, this would make things a lot easier. Just kind of, like, taps his chin. Funny you should mention that.
Funny you should mention
that. Zayn would not know about that.
Yeah. We do have a ship, but it's currently sailing, last we heard, sailing around the Masan Islands?
Yeah, Masan.
Ah.
Yeah.
Captain isn't much of a stick-around type.
May have recruited pirates.
He just kind of like lifts his arms and like, are you fucking serious? sort of way.
I don't believe it either.
I mean, sure.
The alternative is buying a sloop, which, no.
That's not going to work.
Yeah.
Definitely not. Oh boy, I have got my work cut out for me. You don't even seem like a proper army. Has anyone been training you in combat? No?
Do no tournament sounds.
They do not. Oh my god.
Smiles in bard. I can play music.
I snile so sneakily.
You stop that. You stop that sniling.
The sniler.
Can I just say I unironically hate the fucking Sniler meme?
Oh. I have never heard that before now.
What am I talking about? Not the Sniler meme, but like
the visitor.
Adding to the end of things.
Yeah, that one, yeah. Sorry, I'll stop it then.
But apart from that, I guess we're just hunkering down for the night until tomorrow. So if you want to talk with any NPCs or Kanan himself, we have about an hour.
Cool.
So you want to just, like, end session now or whatever.
Yeah. Phoenix is approaching Zaradon.
Oh.
Yes.
That letter you got from... That was from Locke, right?
I presume so, yes.
I heard the mention of Garra's Cove. She kind of like glances towards the southwest, which would be that direction, roughly. I heard the mention of that. It kind of makes me worried.
Is there something in particular about this location? Or just the surrounding elements of the letter?
little of both. it might be where I was born. And I haven't been there for a long time, so she takes a deep breath. If we're heading there, then I feel like I just need to steel myself for this journey.
I suppose we all.
May I see that letter?
Sure, I'll hand it over. Sorry, this is a phone call. I really need to take this, so I'll be back in a couple minutes here.
Okay.
You got a letter.
You
just got a letter.
It's from luck.
It's somehow a video call.
Also, I'm sorry, his first name is Gabriel.
It is.
Yeah. Wow.
Me.
Interesting.
Like, I knew that, but so, like, it didn't, like, register that, yes, players haven't heard that yet.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Learning all sorts of secrets today.
I will, yeah. Zayn, makes, like, a general sort of question. So, when we get into Monai, it's going to be a similar situation to trying to get into San Cordia, i.e. are they going to ID us?
You're asking Kanan this?
Yeah.
Well, they might ID us when we leave, depending on if we want to pass by the actual border. But we're going to Respite. And we're going by way that isn't going to pass by the toll booth, so to speak.
Ah, I see.
Interesting.
I've got my ways around. And trust me, getting from Daga's Pass to here was a bit of a fucking jaunt, let me tell you.
Daga's Pass.
Oh my.
Map is sideways.
Yep, they're always sideways. You're just not looking at them right.
Gotta look from another angle.
That's right, it gives me angle.
That's right, the angle.
So he went, like, up through Poeira.
He was following us. Yeah.
Or he knows a different route.
Interesting.
Oh my god.
Which kind of whittles back around the pole that, or pole there, but yeah.
Seeing you draw the Kanan route is just reminding me of that one scene in Emperor's New Groove with the map.
Yeah.
By all count, it doesn't make any sense.
By all count, it doesn't make any sense.
Oh, no.
Yeah, I don't know. How'd you get here? I don't know.
How did we get here?
Well, you got me. By all accounts, it doesn't make any sense.
Very honest. Anyway, spontaneous step by glamour.
Sorry, it's on my brain.
All right. Sorry about that. I'm back.
Welcome back.
What did I miss?
Zayn asked, basically. Well, see, now I've forgotten what he asked. Yeah,
trying to get into the country over.
Yeah, and then we had this little aside of like, oh no, you don't have to worry about that. I know my own ways into Bornai without having to, you know, get involved with the toll booth, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
Which led us to have a little discussion. It's like, how did you get here, Kanan? I don't know. By all accounts, it doesn't make any sense.
Alright, fun stuff.
So, have you been tailing us then? Catching up to us?
Yes and no. I've been aware of your exploits for a time, but I've been mostly sticking around in Bornai and Genera and the general area. I don't like to spend more time in Poira than is needed because of, well, he kind of just points to his ears.
Damn.
Took me a second to realize.
Someone did.
Oh yeah, no, I haven't forgotten about Ruben.
Yeah, I was about to say, I know you, it's his I son.
Would hope not.
I was like...
All of what you were getting at, huh? Like, did you happen to see...
I have many answers to many questions. The question is, are you going to ask them?
Wait, I have a son? Oh, God.
How did that happen?
Well, you see, when a man and a woman love each other very much... None of that, Kanan. You put that back in there. So-called free thinkers when you're a villager.
The door, I must open it.
Ooh, piece of candy.
Ooh, piece of candy.
What else?
That's a... Oh. Well, I appreciate that reference, but you didn't get the one I was referencing.
Hello.
I think of you all alone.
Oh.
I do want to bring that
make fates jokes.
Yeah, we're making fates jokes. We can make fates jokes now. I've determined it's okay to make fates jokes.
A wound isn't as fresh anymore. Yeah. It was back in 2019.
You know, when we started this, Fire Emblem Fates had just come out, and I had just played through all of it, and I'm like, man, this is, good man.
Nature's healing, we can make fakes jokes.
What do you mean I can marry my brother? Man, fuck. Sucks.
Look, Fates is pretty music, we can appreciate the music.
I mean, yeah, absolutely, like, zero game has bad music in the Fire Emblem franchise.
That's fair.
That's not entirely true. I don't know.
Give it time.
FE7's okay.
Blazing. I like that soundtrack.
Yeah, but even like the least soundtrack is still like fire for Fire Emblem, you know?
It's fire. But yeah.
It's all fire.
I realized what I said immediately after I said it.
It's all fire.
Fire,
it's all fire. Soundtrack. Always has been.
Zayn war flashbacks.
Hey, careful, spoilers.
Phoenix getting excited.
Wait, what?
Oh, nothing. That's... I'm just being silly. Wait, did I give you a brass club or a bronze axe? I wanted to give you the axe.
I do have one that's just...
I gave you a club. What's wrong with me?
Did anyone mention... This is out of character. Did anyone mention what we're doing in Respite? At any point?
Not yet.
Nope.
I guess in character I'd ask, like, so when we get to Respite, Ganon, what do you intend on having us do, or... Yeah, what do you intend on having us do next?
Well, personally, I have to restock on a few supplies. I would recommend you all do the same. But once we reach Respite, we will be meeting with, well, my other employer. I work for the Alboretian royal family as a whole, not just, you know, one guy. Say.
I see.
So, the princess?
The princess, yes. To thicken your accent.
Bro, this guy. So.
It's like hurting teenagers.
I see. Nessa would be a bit nervous of this, but like having answers, she'd be like, alright, cool.
Excuse me, I am over century old.
Only a century.
Oh no.
Yes, that is on the younger side for Manakit, but still older than the rest of you.
It's funny that you think that.
Oh my god, is he a Manakit also?
He might just be.
He did mention pointing at the ears, and I do remember Poop showing us art.
Well.
Well, he's definitely not human. He kind of mentioned that, like, right at the gate.
Yeah.
He did?
He did.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't listen sometimes. Can't read, can't listen.
That's okay. The VOD will be up today.
Friday.
I guess for those of us who are listening today.
Today.
Sure.
Right now.
If you're watching today, viewers, hi, everybody.
Today.
Yes, I'm talking directly to you now. Give me your phone.
Give me your phone.
I need to call for a pizza, and mine has not been working lately.
Aw.
You ever just wonder, like, what the point is?
Every day.
Not, yeah. That wasn't the end of my sentence.
Can I see if Zayn would recognize this guy?
You no, may no. Go ahead and give me a perception check.
Anyway. Oh, that's a crit.
Oh my god, alright.
Critical success. Critical success. Oh yeah, you've seen this guy. Not only have you seen this guy, you know this guy.
Oh my god, I feel stupid.
So, can I...
Nighttime.
You and me need to have a side conversation really quick, I think. Because it would be spoilers to talk about for the rest of the chat.
Cool.
Damn it.
Do we want a recorder over?
No, because it would...
That's up to you. Do you want a recorder over?
Yeah, I don't mind if Vulcan knows. I know he can keep a secret.
All right.
Oh my god.
Well, I mean...
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to Actually, yeah, I did.
The thing is, like, anything that gets heard gets revealed on Friday...
Oh, that's also a good point.
Okay. So, like, if it's going to be spoilers, then it's probably better to leave it as...
I'll leave that up to Robin. Do you want this to be heard by the world?
Okay, no, sorry. I didn't mean to waste your time, Bolt.
Yeah, that's fine. <You're>
fine. Be gone, thought.
Fine.
Okay.
Well... Oh, hey, no, nothing's happening.
Nothing's happening. We're good.
Trying to figure out how the foot came into the fire.
Yeah, no, I saw shit happening, but like I was too busy being like, hold on, if it's spoilers, maybe we shouldn't be recording this.
Yeah.
That's fair.
Then we had the brief discussion of like, well, Robin, do you want it to be said to the world?
Whoa, what the fuck? Ooh. I can zoom in even closer to things now.
Wait, what?
What are you... Hi.
What did I press? Alright, pressing P activates different cameras.
Oh yeah.
And so first person.
Top down. Yeah, I've always used the third person camera.
Same.
Based on the recordings, I thought you might have been using the top down.
Oh no, I just always do top down.
Okay.
I pulled it top down. I didn't realize it was an actual setting.
That's fair. Oh god. Oh god, I don't know if I like the first person.
Yeah, it's
a little unwieldy.
I don't like that. Well, thank you for the zoom in thing. This is helpful.
This is cool.
I do need to fix it.
Alright, this is bugging me. I want everyone to be symmetrical.
Oh god. Oh god.
Actually,
absolutely.
Oh god. Oh god. How did I end up under the table? Why am I stuck under the table?
Hello. Who is stuck under the table?
Hello.
Nothing.
Vulcan fell off the table.
Oh.
Okay.
Don't do that.
Okay, yeah, discovered first person camera.
Yeah, I accidentally slipped through the table going into first person. And go back up shit, through the table.
Yeah. I
accidentally left. I'm coming there. Back.
Back to third person.
I'm just gonna go ahead and
okay.
Give the people who have interacted with him a few support points. There we go.
Hell yeah.
What the? Why are you guys blinding yourselves and not?
What?
Don't worry about it.
Right. Oh, that was me trying to figure out how to flick cannon into the fire.
Dude! Why?
Wait, what?
People left, so shenanigans. It's the rules.
Yeah, it's the rules.
DM's gone, shenanigans ensue. Yeah.
Go sacrifice the sorcerer.
Notice Zaradon is slowly going more northward.
I didn't even notice that!
Or westward.
Wait, where are you going?
I'm going over there. Yeah, just set up camp on higher ground to kind of overlook the campsite.
Oh, cool. Aww.
I don't have a camp for that. But I appreciate your choice.
He just huddles into his armor like a turtle.
Am I not turtly enough for the turtle club? Turtle.
The pink turtle.
Oh my god, I haven't heard a reference to that in a long time.
Really? I think about that movie all the time.
I used to think about that movie all the time.
I guess depending on who you ask, Locke is a master of disguise.
Yeah? He could be Kanan.
He could be you. He could be me. He could even...
He could be what? Zelda.
I could be red, I could be blue, I could be violet sky.
God damn it.
I could be heartful, I could be purple, I could be anything you like.
Exactly.
Gone.
I could copy Ringo. Now there's two of her. Now she's gone.
Oh wait, two Ringos met, we could have taught the horse and dance faster.
Stop it.
Hey, when two Ringos meet up, is that a bushel of apples?
God, now there's two of them.
Nah, it's just Spider-Man's
game. Wait for the hills.
Wee.
We must fulfill the circle.
Yay.
I had it in a sort of specific shape, and now it's a circle. Urkel.
Now it's a dot.
Oh, it's a square.
It could be two
right,
things.
Square.
Stop.
No.
Every day I wake up.
You wake up and just hear Squishy go, "That's right, the square hole."
I lay in bed for 3 hours. It's 4 a.m. I'm terrified. Squishy Pixels, my sleep paralysis demon who does nothing but remind me of square holes.
What's the incorrect shape through all of them?
A little off track today, but that's fine.
Yes.
Yeah.
Today was
yeah.
Kind of a slow RP day. Introduction yeah. To chapter 2, introduction to the convoy, introduction to Kanan, introduction to things that are going to happen.
Hell yeah.
We're learning.
Reflection, new stuff.
A moment of rest against this coming storm.
Until we get to respite.
And then we can have a second one.
Yeah, then we can have a proper moment of respite.
We've had one respite, yes, but what about second respite?
Oh, that reminds me of when I pointed out what respite means to Squishy.
Oh, yeah.
Huh. It's a nice little town.
Little town.
That will happen.
It's a quiet village.
They're not French, though.
If something happens in respite that, like, completely goes against the name of the town.
Definitely. Do you remember what happened last time?
No.
I mean, look at what happened in Calma.
Great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fucking Calma.
I actually don't remember what happened in Respite last time.
Oh, you'll be pleasantly surprised then, won't you?
Yeah. Like, I remember certain events and things that happen throughout the campaign. I just don't know what happened specifically where.
In what order, in what city.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, you'll be shocked, I guess.
I have a generic sense of, like, what order.
Well, I have a genera.
Yeah, don't remind me of genera.
Order.
We don't talk about genera.
We don't talk about food. No.
We don't talk about porn.
No, no, no.
999, yeah.
999.
The science guy.
Damn it. I swear to God, if we could just bottle up all of our ADHD.
I don't know, yeah.
I don't know where that thought was going. I think we were going to be like saying, like, oh, we could make like a cure for it. No.
Yeah, it would make everything
bottling
worse.
A soul. We need to bottle our neurodivergence.
Yeah.
It's HRT for your brain.
Oh.
You go from neurotypical to neurodivergent with this one easy pill. Now you too can wonder why your skin is itchy at 3 a.m.
Oh no.
Yeah.
That's a side effect.
It's actually your bones started itching.
Yeah.
I think they'd be NRT, since it's not hormones, it's neurotransmitters.
Well, I don't know what the words for things are.
Sorry, I like science.
I know you like science. Weird science.
All I know is
anyone want to talk to NPCs instead of just shooting the shit for 5 hours?
Oh.
Apparently we're going to shoot the shit for 5 hours.
Yay!
Yeah,
I talked to Butal last
because
session.
Cut away now. Now I'm like, damn, maybe I should stop talking for a little bit.
Does Ina talk to you? Why do you call my brother baby girl? Maybe we should stop talking for a while. I just realized that that's technically kind of fucked up, actually, to say to Price specifically. You don't know this, he's trans, whatever.
Oh.
It used to be. It's just kind of how transgender works.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Transgender like, beam.
Sure.
I don't really have anyone else to talk to.
That reminds me of something from a Marvel RP server that I had Zayn in. I'll post it after session.
Thank you.
Oh, there we go.
You're welcome.
Yeah, that was not me.
Good. Didn't even notice.
What?
Oh, never mind.
No!
Didn't know we were...
Sacrifice. Sacrifice.
The witch.
No, no witch. Huh.
Human music. I like it.
On the topic of Batal, would Batal be awake?
Wait, sure, you can go find out. She's awake.
All right, I go run up the fire.
Excuse me, pardon me. Excuse me, pardon me.
Excuse me.
Knock on door.
Hey. Hey, mom. I just wanted to. Say it. First off, so sorry about what happened regarding your country. I can't imagine how you or the other players are probably feeling. Especially since you were in that room.
Well, put it bluntly, I suppose it's a good thing I'm in the cause of Alberic, then.
Yeah, we're glad to have you here. I do want you to know, Samus and Ricordia was probably the most pleasant place I've been in. And this has come from someone who spent childhoods fishing with their father down in Poira. Mr. Ricordia seems to be the one place that hadn't changed, and I appreciate that.
Well, I'm glad for you to say so. I just hope that our cause can lead other nations to, well, maybe follow in our general footstep of examining inward what's important.
Exactly. And I do hope that cause, like you said, I hope it does spread.
Country isn't its lands or its borders or its principles, it's its people, first and foremost.
Exactly. I agree wholeheartedly with that sentiment. Like, you don't have a country without its people. Without the people, it's just a bunch of rocks over some water and maybe some wildlife growing on it, but the people are what make it a country.
Mm-hmm. And if pirates want to force their ideals onto the country itself, then it's no country I want any part of.
Likewise, you're very wise.
I've been around a while.
What the fuck are you two doing? Sorry,
I'm absentmindedly tracing lines.
You two look like you're trying to summon
a demon. I'm listening, I just fidget.
I saw it at the corner of my eye.
NPC pinball with hand. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
God. No, I do. I just strive to be. I hope to have as much wisdom someday. Especially after all this.
You'll get there. You've got plenty of years to learn.
Thank you. Have a good night. No, don't say that.
I'm so mean. I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. I mean, if Nessa dies, I get to mass release all her music, so there's a plus.
That's true.
But I have to release all the flutless versions.
Oh.
Mm. Oh, I don't like that.
I hate that.
Me. It's like, Phoenix, quick, use your resurrection spell.
God, that's a scary thought. I don't know. Would Nessa want to be resurrected? That's the thing.
Oh, I didn't.
We have a choice.
That does remind me how in 5e, resurrection spells always specify that the soul of who you're resurrecting has to be willing and able to come back.
I'm glad there's consent for souls.
Yeah, notice that the case in there doesn't have that. Yeah.
Oh, unconscious souls yeah. Don't want me.
That's yeah. That's what I was here. Like, I wasn't mentioned in these rules. This is not 5e.
This is not 5e. This is. And you may ask yourself, wondering, well, where is 5e?
No.
You can ask yourself.
This is not my beautiful class. This is not my beautiful level. And you may find yourself wondering, well, the fuck's with this system?
Where are all the games?
At this point, I don't even know if we're referencing the original song or Orin's cover.
Yeah. Kind of both. Hi, Orin. How you doing?
Hello.
Hi, Orin.
Love the new video, by the way.
We love you, Orin.
I think it's at over 150,000 views now.
Is it?
Jesus.
I have to check the exact number after that. Vulcan, I'm not going to ask you to edit this in, but I'm definitely going to figure out how much it has by Friday. Well, if nothing else, then I suppose this has been a very successful encampment.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Speak now or forever hold your piss.
Yeah, no, I do got to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, go piss.
Good.
Yeah, after recognizing Canon, Zane's shutting the fuck up.
You mean Canon?
Canon?
Canon? Yeah, no. Canon is what has already existed and what may exist.
The Canon shoots giant ballistics.
Oh, you want Canon? Hang on. You want Canon?
God.
Uh-oh.
Oh. My God.
Huh? Yeah,
the dice game.
Does it fire?
All right, time
to find out.
Yeah!
Oh my God!
Hang on. Who wants to be the willing sacrifice?
All right, here.
Wait, hang on. Let's copy you so that you don't disappear. Okay, where's the load button?
Dear Lord.
I don't think it has a load button.
Do we just put him in the mouth?
Yeah, just put him in the mouth. Yeah.
Zane
Ready?
Phoenix.
Aim.
We're still in there.
Are you? Wait, no, hang on.
Yeah, pick there's... up. Yeah, you gotta select them and then there's the load button.
Oh.
Oh.
I see. It has to go farther back in. Fire.
Where did they go?
They're gone. Oh no, they're there. They're here. Thanks for playing, everybody.
Yeah, thank you.
We ended the session off with a bye.
Team.
Goodbye. All right.
Bye.
That's a good ending.